like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion, like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one match, but I can make an explosion. And all those things I didn't say were wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned up. Starting right now. I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And I don't really care if nobody else believes, 'cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In too deep, say I'm in too deep. In too deep. And it's been 2 years, I miss my home. But there's a fire burning in my bones. I still believe, yeah, I still believe. And all those things.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, good morning. Welcome to this Saturday morning talk show. And for all the listeners in Australia and Asia, welcome. If you could hear me loud and clear, please type in just one word, how you feel this morning, at the bottom of the chat box. Happy, Sabrina. Oh, that's good. My name is Carol and I'm from Perth, Australia. I'll be your host for this morning. I would like to thank Sabrina for organizing this talk and giving me this great opportunity to interview our special guest for today. So, great. Okay, relax. Oh, that's fantastic. Ready? Yes, we are all ready. Okay, so this morning, our special guest, I've seen this lady in Sydney Convention, each time when I went to Sydney Convention. And every time when I remember seeing her, she's always sitting at the corner, smiling, knocking her head. And, you know, she's so humble, so humble. So I remember the first time seeing her, she was actually, I was wondering, who is this lady? You know, keep on smiling. And then when she got up the stage, I realized that she's actually Australia top earner. And she is Australia first Million Dollar Club member. Wow. Such a lovely lady, such a humble lady. Okay. So we are today, we are going to learn from Anne. And I know that many of us are curious, who is Anne Loke? And then some may wonder, so why is she so successful? Aren't we all curious to find out? Yes, we do, right? So I know that we would like to have some question. And you know, after my interview with Anne, you can key in your question on the Q&A button. If we do have time, we will answer it together with Anne. All right. So before, so let us welcome Anne. Hi, Anne. Good morning, Anne.
I'm going to on my video. Sorry.
It's okay. Good morning. Good morning, Anne.
Yes.
Okay, Anne, thank you for joining us this morning. I've read your profile and understand that you are always a high achiever and you always looking for opportunity to earn a lot of money. Okay. I understand that when you're young, you only have secondary school education. Okay, so you're not a graduate or whatever, but you are always keen, always eager, always on the go. And you have that business spirit in you to want to earn more, to always want to strive the best. That's you. Okay, when you're young, you open a mini supermarket. You are the top achiever, top salesperson in Shiseido Cosmetic. You even did so well in Amway, Causeway. You even run your very own MLM company, set up your very own MLM company in Australia. So what made you look into Market Australia? How did you start this business?
Hello, thank you for Carol. Thank you for Sabrina organize this for me to share my, because usually know I'm quite shy and not talking to the public, but I'm very honored to have you all invite me. Actually, I'm the one, I think I get my father's, my father is an entrepreneur. He come from China from 13 years old and he built really a big business through our family. So I grow up, I always go out with him, hear his story. That's why I always want to make something greater. But you know, life is the journey. As long as you want to stretch. So I go through different type of, you know, business and different type of network marketing when I married to my dear husband. He want me to stay at home. So, but after I go through all these things, I feel, why let other people earn? Why don't I start my own MLM? So I started, but I found it's not so easy. So keep on looking for opportunity until one day, my sponsor, Roger, bring me a book because he go to the city and Melissa Chen pass him the MA compensation plan. So he know that I always tell him, I'm looking for something, looking for a better plan. So he passed the book to me. Then I go back and study the plan. And I say, is that too good to be true? Straight away, I see. You see, that is how I think. It's not I'm smart or what. It's God give me wisdom. So I know this is the best business. I do my research, of course. Go into internet and research about all market America. And then I feel this is the right one. I'm going to be in it and put my full heart in it. That's why I come to market. Wow.
Okay, that's great. So have you ever thought that you'll be so successful and to become the top earner and Australia first $1 million club member? Have you ever thought about that? And what is your key to your success?
I think I never. I just know that I want to do my best. I always ask God wisdom. I pray to God, say, God, if you want me to build this business to help others, I know this business, you have to be successful if you need to help other people successful first. So I know this principle. So I said, God, you send the right people in my pathway. That's why this is what I'm persistent to do it. And it happened. You see, it's not say, I need to be the first or what, I'm not that type of people. But it just happened, you see. I see it's God. Yeah, they send me a lot of good leaders. I will thank for them in my organization. Yes.
And to my knowledge, it is not easy to start Market Australia business during your time. I understand that it's very expensive. There's so limited goods, products, and there's no fast start kit at all, no online shopping, nothing at all. So how did you do it?
Okay, I think I just look at the plan, because I feel the plan is so simple. Because when I want to create my own network marketing, I also look at other people's plan, so complicated, but this is too simple. It's like sharing economy. I see it. Everybody do a bit. So I think if I do my best, I will be. So starting the point is changing buying habit. That is the first thing you have to know. So when I start this business, I start to talk to my husband. Sorry, I cannot use all the product you buy. You know, my husband always buy. Oh, this is on sale. This, no, like. Detergent, and I said, I have to stop using that. I need to do all the product that my company provide. That's why I just look at the bright side. You know, whatever they have, I just do it. Then it happened.
So just changing habits, changing buying habits.
Anyway, you buy other brand, why don't you, and the company give up when the financial report, I also look at the financial report, they give up more than 50%. Which company can share you this type of profit sharing? Even I buy share, because before that, I usually buy share. The dividend is how much, you know. So this is what I see.
Okay. Now, definitely when doing this business, you will meet a lot of challenges. Okay. Yes. So how do you overcome those challenges? And what is your most difficult challenge that you have faced during for this business?
I think when you know you find the right one, just like, no, I'm Christian, believe in God. If I know that God was helping me, I will go on it, no matter how people talk about it. You see, I will share the gospel, same thing. In this business, also the same. So I go through, when I go prospecting, I think, of course, you will meet people and all these things, but I don't look at the dog. I just think that what I need to do, what I need to help, what I need to help the, you know, the society to change the world thinking. I really have a JL thinking because I listened to JL Basic Five many times. So I don't look at the dog. I just go forward. I think if you are thinking of manage people, it's the hard part. But I know everybody have their own character, own thing. I just look at the bright side of them. So I will go ahead. That's how I go through all this challenge.
Okay, that's great. And now the million dollar question. Have you ever thought of giving up?
Never. Actually, it's true. In my diary, I would never give up. It's true because I feel, why you give up this simple plan? If you understand the plan, it's so simple that a lot of people don't believe. When I see the requirement, 150B is the higher requirement, which investment can give you this type. If you look at the company, it's so fair. Even I earn this money, everybody start with the same platform. This is what I say. When I look at Joanne, when Joanne come, I see her, she can do it. Of course I can. And Joanne share and Elizabeth Weber when we started. So I never think of give up because I feel if they can do it, I can. Especially I have God is my partner. That's how I'm thinking.
All right, okay. I just love your determination and the never give up attitude. Fantastic. So what would you say to people who look into this business plan? They're saying, oh, this is 2 to 3 years. And then after that, they give up halfway. Yes. So, you know, what is the advice to people?
I always think that they have to check themselves first and the timing. And they have to keep on. This is a number game. Keep on talking to people. Of course, some will say no and all this thing because they don't understand. You have to understand. They don't understand how good is our plan. Of course, so we have to be patient. If they want to give up, they have to check themselves. Why this plan is so simple? Why I give up? So you check what are the point that why you want to give up? Because of you can't get people in or what. So you change your time and go for training. I feel training is the most important. When you go on, even you don't get the result, you will never give up. You see? So go for more training and different leader have a different type of teach you. Maybe one word will touch you. And it's not a lot of money compared to any other business. You want to earn 100,000. Can you get this little capital to earn this type of money? No, there's no way.
Okay, so that's good.
Please don't give up.
All right, another question is, before you earn this money, okay, that is way you started. So how do you convince people that this is actually the best way to earn money? this is a good business? How you convince them in the early days?
Okay, I usually not comment, but when people see my excitement, just like my business partner who come in when I started, actually when the business I know is on March, but they launch on June, I already start to sharing. Any party, I just say, hey, I find a best business, a best plan in the world, like we can all work together. So those people in the early day, they can know how I get them. Even in any party and anything, I will bring up because I know this is the best one. So it's not convinced. I think it's your posture and your belief people can see it. If you think that you want to convince people, there is nobody can be convinced. If you have to convince yourself first, then you will have the thing, you know, people can see that you convince yourself. Then they will follow you. If you are not, why? So think of that.
Yes, the posture, positive.
Yes, the posture, positive.
That is fantastic. Now, I understand that you have a big team in Australia, in Malaysia, and Singapore. So how do you manage them? How do you motivate them and create that synergy together?
I think you have to lead by example. Just like even in Singapore, in anywhere. And usually, just like I remember, I don't know how to reach out to, but they will reach out to me. So when they need any help, I will go. That is the thing. I think raise up leader. And I always say, it's God's will. God always send me good leader. That leader that you just teach them a few, but for the beginning, of course you need. And then they will catch it and they will do it with or without you. So leader is more important. So you need to spend time with the leader first. Then later on, you spend time with people who are down, they are not yet leader, but they will see you, your concern when they reach out to you, you will try. So any people in my organization, you have, if they reach out to me, I will take time to talk to them. That is me. Okay. That is very important.
Yeah. And how do you identify leaders? How do you, you know, what are the qualities that, you know, that you identify them? How do you identify them?
Okay. I think leaders, first, they have to be follow the system. They have to like the product. If they don't like the product, there's no talk already. You see? And they have to believe that they can. Second thing, and they have to do action, not just talk. So when you see that they have this type of quality, you know they are leader quality.
Okay. So now that I know that now that you have retired, okay, you're enjoying yourself, you know, with your grandchildren, with your family. So I still, you know, hear that you're always involved in your team and always involved in the activity. So with your position, having a nice income, why are you still coming out and doing all these activities?
Actually, I retired is from the front, you know, but I'm doing at the back is my passion. It's not the money, you see. I'm not the one that can, stand up and say, you know, I am the one behind because I see a lot of people in my team, they need me, you see, and it's my passion. So whatever they phone me, reach out to me, I will never say no or no time, no, because it's because of I have very good leader, they all out front, you see. So I can stay behind the scene and look at all these little one. They just want to start it, you see. Because by you doing this, you also help your team, your leader. Because the leader will be very busy. So I have the time to reach out to people who are just started or have a difficulty or discouraged. That's what I reach out to them.
Do they remind you of when you started the business?
Of course. Yes.
The difficulties and the challenges that they are facing?
Yes. Yeah. If they ask me anything, I will give them answer.
Okay, that's fantastic. So what are the top two tips that you will give business owners like us?
I think if you think the world, now the world is you fight me, even in the world now, economy, even US and you know, China can see. Everybody think of them, you see? But this business is very God principle. You have to think of other first. So when you see that people that you want to help and they are struggling, so you will put up your hand and, you know? So this is the thing that I see, you know? So I'm thinking of, because the plan is so perfect, that's why I really thank JR and the corporate team give us a perfect plan in this world. Now I cannot see any plan like us in the business. So in this business, you have to help your people successful before you can suffer. So, and you have to forgive, forget, and you have to look at always the people bright side, and you have to don't look at the dog. I feel if you look at the, no one are perfect. No, in this world, no company are perfect, but the plan is perfect.
So the plan is the one that attracts you.
Correct. The plan is the one who attracts me.
So the plan, the residual income?
Yes.
Is it the one that attracts you?
Of course. Because this plan is that you work hard 2 to 3. So I always tell them, I rather work hard few years and retire, you know, and behind the scenes few years. Because the first few years, you had to create the momentum for your team. If you are not doing what you want your team to do, you have to lead by example. You don't lead when you don't go. That's it.
Okay, that's good. That's amazing, amazing. And thank you so much. I learned so much from you today. And I know that you're very determined. You're very focused. You're an amazing woman. You're always so humble and always reach out to your team and wanted to help them and wanted to see everyone to be successful. No wonder you are a top earner and no wonder you are the first $1 million club member. So how do you feel now, not being so successful, being a grandma, a rich grandma, and your children are enjoying the fruit of your hard work? So what's your feeling?
My feeling is that I hope everybody can be like me. All the people who listen to this, you can. If I can do it, you can. Just keep on changing your mindset. This is the best plan. If you can find something is better than it, of course. 行行出状元. But if you can't find something that this, that don't need a lot of money, just with your heart and helping other, you will reach it. It's matter the timing.
Okay, that's good. Thank you, Anne. So now let us move to the next session. I would like to introduce my partner, Kitty. Oh. Yeah, Kitty.
Hello there. Thank you, Carol, for the first session. It was amazing. And thank you, Auntie Anne Loke, for your wisdom and your insights. I've learned so much from you. So today, you know, in the second session, we are going to be sharing about our personal experience and our life with Auntie Anne, how she's been helping us, as well as some of the other friends that I've invited to also share the same. So let me start off just with my own experience with Anne. Well, I always call her Auntie Anne because she's really like my auntie, you know, she's so loving, and she's not only just my senior business partner and my leader, she's also my role model, she's my example, and she's always been encouraging me along my journey of being an unfranchised owner. And as a leader, you know, she has amazing qualities. I mean, if I had a lot of time, I could go on for like till this afternoon. But, you know, some of the main things that I like to share is that she has vision. She knows what she wants to achieve. That is very much like JL. And she has resilience. And I know that she's been through quite a fair bit of challenges throughout her career with Market Australia, shop.com. Yet she's so resilient and she always stands back up after any struggles. And she's empathetic, you know, whenever any one of us who has experienced any struggles or difficulties, she empathizes and she understands. And she's very humble and down to earth. You know, she is the top lady of Market Australia, but she is so humble. If you actually, you know, want to talk to her anytime, she is, as she mentioned, always available, you know, for her team to, you know, encourage us and give us support and wisdom. And she's so positive as well. And so, you know, all of these different qualities and many, many more are really something that I really personally admire a lot. That is why she's so amazing and you know, successful. And I would like to particularly share three things today that really inspire me and impress me about Auntie Anne Loke. First is how serious she takes training. As she already said, you know, she takes training so seriously to the point that I can see, especially nowadays when we have so many Zoom trainings, she would go to majority of them, if not all of them. And not only that, she would also remind us every single time, you know, oh, these are the different trainings, make sure you attend, and she would tell all of her team as well. And she certainly really leads by example, because whenever I go onto a Zoom meeting of any kind, whether it's, you know, things like corporate meetings or GMTSS, UBP, as well as a lot of our corings, because you know how big her team is, right? Like, you know, she has so many leaders that run various coring, and she's always on. When I'm on, Auntie Anne is always on. That is truly leading my example. I don't see many leaders that actually do that all the time. And she, being the top multi-million dollar club member, as well as executive director, the top one in Australia, she would do that. And that is something that is really amazing. And I certainly want to learn from her, because I surely believe that training and knowledge, attitude are built by attending events like this. Second thing that I really admire and appreciate about Auntie Anne is how much she loves God and how much she loves people. You can see already from what she shared with Carol earlier on, she always brings glory to God, and she believes that God actually helps her in everything that she does, of course, including this business. And so I have actually been so encouraged by that, because she said that God brought all her leaders to her. And in my time with Market Australia right now, I am looking for leaders that really I want to bless and support. And I know that God will also bring me leaders, just as how she brought leaders to Auntie Anne, even though it may be a matter of time, but it's not, it will happen, right? So that is something that Auntie Anne keeps on sharing with me that really encourages me. So I will not give up. I will find the leader. I will headhunt the leader to the point that I will find someone just like Auntie Anne or Auntie Angie or Uncle Kevin, people like them. And the third, and but not the last, but not least, is she has a way to really inspire people to do the things that they never thought they could. One example for me personally is she actually approached me, you know, to do a number of things like leading a big group of coring alongside my amazing leaders, Angie and Kevin as well. always encourages me to do things that I thought, I don't know if I can do it, but she believes in me. The fact that, you know, Auntie Anne Loke believes in me makes me want to do better and achieve my goals and bring glory to God at the same time. So that is what I want to share. I could go on and on, but we don't have time today. But thank you, thank you, thank you, Auntie Anne, for all that you've done, you know, to help me and many others in your team and Market Australia by large as well.
Thank you, Kitty.
I love you, Auntie Anne. So Next, I have invited, as I mentioned, a number of really good friends of mine to also do some sharing about what they think of Auntie Anne. So the next person that I have is Elvin. Elvin, if you can actually come on to share with us about your experience with Auntie Anne. Elvin is from Perth, and even though, you know, he's not directly in Auntie Anne's group, he has been impacted by her. Okay, so Elvin.
Good morning. Good morning, everyone. I'm very honored to be part of this great history. It's unusual, as you all know, it's unusual circumstances, but normally I only get to see Auntie Anne once a year in Australian convention. She's our Aussie legend, as you can see from her history and her testimonials. More importantly, first time I met her, and the corporate team has basically showed me how powerful this company is. Everyone is very humble and down to earth in regards to it, especially Anne. Her story and her journey inspired me. I love how down to earth, her kind and generosity. She's always willing to help others. I've seen many of her smiles. And more importantly, I've taken away three great things from her today. Training, listening to audio, and help others to succeed. Like everything she says, never give up. So thank you all for this opportunity. Thanks.
Thank you, Alvin. Appreciate that. And next, I've got another really good friend of mine from Melbourne, Chelsea, who is also part of our, you know, Committed Melbourne group, who is going to be sharing. Chelsea, can I ask you to come up and share with us, please? Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Not sure why my video is not on. So sorry about that. Can somebody else go first and I'll try to fix my video?
Okay, no problem. Yep.
Yeah, sorry.
We have not only one, but two people who are an amazing couple and close friends of mine. I've worked very closely with them, even though we're not on the same team. We've been really working wonderfully together. Both of us are under Auntie Anne Loke's organization. And this wonderful couple is Lily and Hong. Please come up and share with us. Hello. Please unmute yourself.
Good morning, everyone. So excited to be part of this great interview with Anne. Well, I'll just go first and then Hong will cover the end. When I have known Anne probably for over 18 years now. And do you know how I got to know her? Doing what she does best, which is asking people, who do you know? So she must have said that to her sister, who is a good friend of mine, and the sister, when she was looking into starting the business. So the sister actually arranged a lunch. So I was invited to a lunch, and the sister, Bi Hong, told me, said, come along, you know, my sister is back from Australia. I think you all two should connect. And that was how Anne got my number, got our telephone number, and being Anne, she is like a bulldog. She is persistent. She never gave up, you know, despite the many times that we said, no, we're not really into it, but she is good. She knows what she wants and she goes for it. So when I first met Anne, I thought, oh, she's such a quiet lady, so, you know, so quiet. And the first time I met her, it was Dr. Chuan who was doing all the talking, you know, but she's the brain behind the business. So thank you very much, Anne, for being there for us, never giving up on us. The number of times we have knocked her back, I don't know how she put up with us, but she has. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anne. Anne Loke and her husband, Dr. Chuan, my relationship was more with Dr. Chuan because we went to the same university. He was doing medicine and I was doing engineering. So I knew Chuan from way back. And it was really much later that I met Anne through my wife, Lily, and her friends and et cetera. And really, in terms of talking about Anne, in our home, we call her the pocket rocket. All right. She's really a dynamo pocket rocket. And the thing that she keeps, I suppose, as Lily says, reminding us and working, encouraging us, is the fact that you can see the passion in her. Right? And the passion is one thing. And as I think Kitty said, her relationship with God. Lily and I are Buddhists, but you know, ours is a philosophy, so we are open to all churches, and we've been to her church several times when we were in Sydney. Yes, and so, you know, God and Loke is very, very close. And the passion that she has is really, market Australia is her passion. And a small secret, the second passion, I think, is Korean's TV shows, right? That's the other passion she has, I think, other than, and as well as her family and all her other friends. And the other thing that I really admire about Anne is the fact that she actually goes a lot for the details as well, right? We don't know that, but occasionally she'll ring up and she'll say, oh, so-and-so who is down here, you know, is doing such and such. And we say, oh, okay, all right, let me have a look, all right? And that happens very often, right, to Lily and I. And the thing that really, Kitty alludes to that, is the action, right? In the background, she does a lot of talking, chatting, cajoling, convincing, and persuading. That's to the people that she has. And I think several, Carol may have even asked the question, I agree with what Anne says, you know, we don't convince the people outside. Someone as successful as Elizabeth Weber, JR, if they walk down the street, they'll just be another person, same as Anne, right? It's only the people who are in the business, whether in Malaysia, Singapore, or wherever it is, will soon learn, because they understand that our success is based on helping other people. Right. Yes. And that's exactly what Anne has said, right? So back to you, Kitty.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the opportunity.
Thank you.
Oh, I absolutely agree with everything you say. You know what? My mother also loves Korean movie, Auntie Anne. So you and her have a lot to talk about. All right, next I think Chelsea is ready. So I'll pass the time for you then. Chelsea, thank you so much. Please unmute yourself.
Thank you so much, Kitty. Thank you for the opportunity to share from my heart. I've got so many things to say. Like Kitty said, I will talk to you the afternoon, but we only have a few minutes. So my name is Chelsea. Some of you know me as Chin Wei. I'm actually based in Melbourne as well. I've known Anne Loke, and I call her Auntie Anne as well, because that's how our senior partners in Singapore call her, for about 2.5 years. So my husband, Huey, met Auntie Anne first. He went to the Sydney Convention in 2017 when we first started the business, not long after we started the business. He didn't know anyone. Through our senior partner, Michelle Liu, Anne was so kind to let Huey stay at her house. And then a couple of months down the road, when I decided to take this business seriously, I started having a lot of complaints, actually. I didn't know how to do it properly, and then I even called corporate and make a lot of complaints. Actually, it's through that I was introduced to Auntie Anne. Corporate told me that I need to speak to Anne Loke. So my first impression of Auntie Anne, I was actually over the phone. She called me, and it was a Saturday morning when I was at the soccer field with my children's soccer game. We had a good chat. Can't remember how much of the details, but I definitely remember something. She got the message that I'm serious about this business and I'm coachable, and I really covered her guidance on how to build this business. So subsequently, we had quite a lot of long phone calls where Auntie Anne got to know me better. And in December 2017, Auntie Anne was in Melbourne for holidays, and we invited her and her husband to our house for lunch. We picked them up from Port Melbourne, and my first impression of Auntie Anne was, she's very warm, very small, but with a very big heart. There are so many things, like I said, I learned from Auntie Anne, and I used to spend many hours on the phone with her in my beginning journey. Today, I'll just share three key things. And the first one is mindset, the entrepreneur mindset. Auntie Anne, as you heard earlier on in today's session, you heard that she started her entrepreneur journey since she was in her late teens with her father. On the other hand, my father taught me to study hard, get a good education, get a good job, climb the corporate ladder, which I've been doing fairly well in the past 20, 30 years. Hence, my mindset shift for me wasn't easy at all. So I actually wrote in my goal statement, the first sentence, which I read twice a day, I, Chinwei Yao, will from now on, will switch my mindset from an employee to an entrepreneur. Without this mindset, the choices and action one will take will be quite different actually. Without that mindset, you will not see the amazing strength of our business model and you won't be sharing feverishly about this business with others. Without this mindset, you will prefer to buy other products than our exclusive products for one reason or another. Or you will choose to buy from a known partner store, even though it's a little bit cheaper than our partner store. So that non-mindset shift will then duplicate to your team and hence reduce your ability to earn the income you want. So the first thing first, I learned that very, very important thing from Auntie Anne. And the second thing that I learned from Auntie Anne is, she said to me, you have to give first. Auntie Anne taught me that in this business, you need to have a big heart. You have to give first. And I can see that she's leading by example. When Auntie Anne first coached me in the business, we don't really have a team yet. She introduced us to her leaders in the Melbourne team. And together we form a cross-team group. And I took leadership of that group, coached by Auntie Anne. I learned so much through this journey and from the other Melbourne leaders, whom some of you have met today, like Kitty and Hong and Lily and Hong Ling and so on. And they have taught me so much things for this business. And because they have been in this business much more longer than me. And the third thing that Auntie Anne taught me is you have to focus on your team first. Although Auntie Anne coached me to do the things that I need for the cross team that I was leading, she constantly reminds me that I need to focus on my team first and grow my own business. That's why my husband is not here today, although he would love to be here. He's actually showing plan to some prospects. Auntie Anne said, you need to do what your team need first. As with everyone, the beginning journey is most difficult and we face a lot of challenges and sometimes getting really, really discouraged as well. But Auntie Anne will always say this to me, you will be successful as long as you don't give up. And that sentence always rings in my heart, in my mind when I feel discouraged. So Auntie Anne will spend time going through with me, looking at my organization chart, teach me where I should focus and what is the strategy I should move forward with. Now that we have a sizable team, I can completely understand this wisdom that Auntie Anne taught me from the very beginning. And I now live and breathe what she had taught me from the beginning of my journey. Although I don't spend many hours with Auntie Anne anymore on the phone, I know deep down in my heart, Auntie Anne is very proud of me. And she has raised me to be a good leader, knowledgeable and independent. So now I'm duplicating what Auntie Anne has taught me, which is to identify leaders who are coachable in my team and raise them to be a good leader, knowledgeable and independent. I continue to wish Auntie Anne to raise many, many more leaders in Market Australia, which inherently will grow her own business as well as the Market Australia market. Thank you.
Thank you, Chinwei. Very proud of you.
Chinwei, wow, you make me want to cry as well. I just want to also say thank you, Chinwei, for agreeing with Hui together to start off the Melbourne Committee Group as Auntie Anne had encouraged you. And because of that, you know, a lot of us are working very well together in Melbourne now. So thank you, Chelsea. Really, really loved your sharing. All right. So my final speaker for sharing about Auntie Anne this morning is a dear friend of mine from Perth, is the beautiful Josephine. And she's really has been someone that I admire from afar as well, for her to share, even though again, she's not directly under Auntie Anne's organization. She has something she would like to share with us about how Auntie Anne has impacted her. So Josephine, I'll pass the time to you. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you, Kitty, for this opportunity. Okay, now I've heard of Anne being our first millionaire club member in Australia since my very early days in this business about 9 years ago. Now, personally, I first saw Anne at my first Sydney convention in 2014. Now, as a lot of speakers have shared, now my first impression of her was that she was a very tiny lady on stage, but wow, the minute she got on stage with Jessica, you could just feel her power, and just feel her aura spreading through the whole field. So that was something that impressed me a lot. Now, the thing that personally, as a mother of three, Anne has actually totally inspired me, not on over the years, at every convention, at every occasion where we do get to hear her to speak, and definitely she has continued to influence and impacted many of us, especially in Australia, when we know that it's definitely not one of the easiest countries to build our business in. Mm-hmm. Now, how has she impacted me personally? Now, being a mother of three, I can see that Anne is totally committed to building this business to build a legacy, which I'm totally all about. So I started this business to build the legacy, and it's so powerful to see Anne and Jessica on stage sharing how our business can not only enrich Anne's life, but now through Jessica and her grandchildren and Anne's grandchildren, we can see the legacy continuing. And I think that is something that all of us should aspire for. I mean, many of us come from different backgrounds. We may be single, we may be maybe in a relationship, or we may be married. Whatever relationship we are in, I think it's important that we build that legacy, because we don't know when we're going to need it. Now, the second thing that Anne has always impressed me, or you know, that I share, that I feel very similar with, is that like Anne, I'm a very quiet person. People who know me know that public speaking is actually definitely not one of my forte, but through the years, through Anne, through many leaders, slowly I'm starting to get out of my comfort zone. And I think what I really like about Anne is that her witnessing her success throughout this journey shows that this business is catered for everyone who's passionate and coachable, and possess the determination to implement the without preserving activities that we need to achieve our time and financial freedom. Thank you everyone for this opportunity, and thank you Anne for your inspirational sharing as always. Thank you, Kitty.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm. All right, so thank you everyone who shared, and let's actually go on to our third session. And yes.
That's the Q&A.
Yep,
let's Q&A, okay, we just select, due to the time limit, we just select a few. So the first question for Anne, how do you normally share the business to a new person? How long do you build the relationship for Pyro to bringing the business up? That's the first question.
Okay, when you see a people that you don't know them much, but listen to them and just bring up the business, say, oh, they usually ask you what you're doing. So I said, I'm on franchise business online. If they don't respond anything, please don't continue. See, just build relationship first. Get their contact, send them, because it's not the timing. But if they're curious, then you know it's all right. And see their body language. If they look like you, then you know this is not the right people. But if they are very, you know, they like to talk to you, then you have the chance. So you have to qualify them before you talk to them the business.
Okay.
That's so true.
Yeah. So the second question is, what is about market, America, market Australia, that you think is different from Causeway, Amway, and other MLM companies?
Yes, because of the plan, the paper. Because I'm the one who looks through a lot of plan. If I know, let's say, Causeway, New Skin, so USANA, I always go to detail and look at the plan. The first thing I already know, they can't tell you how much you can earn, what the maximum you need to do. You know, our plan tell you everything out front. We don't hide anything. We don't say this. So I've been in Causeway Stockies. I see all the people come to me, and when they, you know, they had to claim the commission through me last time. And I see they earn so little. But because I'm stockist, I earn more because all come to me. And I also let them sell a lot of different products, because they are just selling. They don't know how to build team. and the team is not that they can reach the money that they want. So actually, Market Australia is telling you everything upfront as long as you follow the system. It's true, if today I want to do 150 points, is that my income is there? Definitely. Can you see the difference? If you can't see this difference, then I can't say anything, you see? So the difference is we know what are the minimum, you need to do what the maximum. Of course, you want to earn more, you do the maximum. Just like you strip everything, you got a lot of baby to bless others. Is that good?
Yes, that's good. So how do you handle when asked if this is a MLM?
Okay, I will say definitely no. Because it's not, we are like franchise online, I always tell them. As long as you want to know, make an appointment. Don't argue with them. Don't say, oh, because they. You want to know what's the difference? Come, make an appointment. That's it.
Okay. Don't talk too much. So how do you build the momentum with team or organization?
I think this I can get the credit to my sponsor, Roger. When we start this business, he is the one who always organize meeting and things. So we had the momentum. So I know the momentum is the very important thing. That is how I built mine when I started. Although now he's left the business, but I still think that he also teach me a way. So we always organize meeting in different places. Those who start with me, they will know. Yeah. So you need to organize meeting and the binding so that you have the momentum, your team will follow. Just like now is the best time. Do more Zoom with your team, you see, and do cross team. That's another team I know. Because if you talk to your own people, they don't believe in you. But if cross team, they will see, because we don't have any financial, you know, gain. But we gain all each other's knowledge and the way we do business, we share. So Market Australia is the best one. That's why we have GMNTSS. So we are not competition with each other. Our competition is other network, not MA. See, we need to make MA proud.
Oh, that's fantastic. So Kitty, shall we go on to our fun question?
Let's do that. Here we are. Okay, let me just ask Auntie Anne some questions. Let's get to know more about Auntie Anne. All right.
Okay.
Carol, you can go ahead.
All right. Are you able to share your screen, Kitty?
I've shared already. Can't you see?
No.
Yeah, I can see the screen.
Okay, I'll share again. Okay, I thought you.
So this question, and no thinking, you have to answer quickly.
Okay.
First thing that come to your mind, all right?
Yeah, okay.
So the first question is, What are your favorite Market Australia product? This is one of the Q&A question.
Okay, OPC. Well. OPC3, yes.
All right, if there is a time travel machine, what will you do differently in building your shop.com business, Auntie Anne?
There is a time travel machine?
Going back when you first started, would you do anything differently?
I think I have to differently is I have to understand, I have to build more relationship with my team leader and all these things, because I'm not the one, know how to, this is what I think I feel in this. I have to understand my leader more.
Understand your leader more. Yeah, that's a good one.
What was your most memorable convention and why?
I Okay, I think most convention, my first one is the one that I feel in, even in now, before I start, because they give me the whole, the magic moment, you know, yeah. When I attend the first convention, I know, wow, this company is so good.
Fantastic. All right, well, what is your favorite pastime and hobby?
Okay, I think if I say my hobby, my pastime is my business, you would laugh at me, okay? Yes, because I put MA is number one. When I do anything, when people call me, my husband would say, oh, you tired? But when people ask you MA, you go, oh, wake up, you see? So my hobby, I think gardening a bit. Yes, I like gardening. And pastime, like Korean movie.
Oh, yes. You like Korean movie.
I think how can we know? Because they live with me, they know that I enjoy Korean movie.
Yes. They... So you enjoy also doing the business as well.
Yes, it's a relaxing.
So what is the most enjoyable trip in your lifetime and with who?
I think with family. I feel that God give us the family for us to take responsibility. So if I have, that's why now I have a lot enjoyable. I try to manage every year, at least we go one or two in family trip. Like enjoy grandchildren, because you have a close time that what, because always God said, you know, the family is the, you know, the children is the, how God
said? Heritage.
Yes. So I really enjoy my family, yes, with my family. And the second one is convention. I can see all my leader. And I can see all the team there. Yeah.
Fantastic. So who are the three people in your life today that you admire and respect? And who are those three people and how have they influenced who you are and what you've done in your life?
Okay. My first one, I would say my husband.
Mm.
Yeah, he really impact my life a lot because I don't know God that time. But he's so patient and so this one. Yeah, that's what I expect. And no, second is JR. Although I didn't meet to be, but I can see he's so genius. He create this plan really to help the world. And he creates so many millionaires. Okay? Yeah, and the third one, I think I can see is my father also. My father really impact my life.
Wow.
So what's your favorite UnFranchise video or audio?
Okay, I think get to basic, the JR Basic 5, yes. I've been listening so many times, you know, in the cassette tape at that time. I always say, again, I get all from him, you see.
Wow, that's a tip. I think we should all go and listen.
You go back to listen. It's
all the time.
Yeah, even say he want to turn us into a tablet so that we understand him.
Yeah, and that tablet gives us PV, right, Auntie Anne? Okay, so Auntie Anne, how did you encourage your family to work with you? Which is really amazing considering many of us don't actually have families working with us.
Okay, I always talk to them. I never force any family join me. I always tell them why this MA changed our family life and all these things. If they want the business, they have to come out and work with me or else it's go to charity. I already tell them straightforward. It's true because of then they know. You see, they will value it, you see. That's why, and they can see my passion. Because when you're successful, your children will think whether they want to live the lifestyle like you. But right. Don't say build for them, please. They have to come and build themselves.
Wow. Okay.
That's good. You always give glory to God. How has God helped you in this business?
Everything. When I'm down, when I need wisdom, I will pray to him. When I get discouraged, I will say, why God, this thing happened? Why this thing happened? And God will say, okay, think of that. Love. Love whatever. Love is God. Love whatever they are. You will overcome this. Because why we can forgive our husband, our children, because we love them. So we also forgive and forget those who hurt us.
Wow, that moved me.
That is wow. That's amazing.
I love that. That is just the best. Okay, so Auntie Anne, what would you do in your me time to relax?
I already tell you, is the Korean, but I make sure I listen to God's message every morning. So I don't want me to be in the world. I need to tie with what I do and tie with God together and take action, not just read Bible or listen, but make sure we take action.
Fantastic. Wow.
Wow.
All of those answers, right, Carol?
Yes, yes, amazing. Yeah.
Thank you, Auntie Anne. But last but not least, this is
last question. Yes, this is the big question. So you are a rich grandma. You build a legacy for your children, for your grandchildren, for generations to come. All right? And you're such a successful woman. So if you look back in your life now, so what is your magic moment?
Oh, my magic moment. Oh, when I meet my husband.
Wow. So
he really bring God to our family. Without him, I don't know God. That is true.
How did you meet him?
Oh, somebody organized a dinner. That's it. And I'm his first girlfriend and he's my last boyfriend.
Oh, la la. Boyfriend. I love that.
First girlfriend and last boyfriend.
That's really magical, isn't it, Carol? Yes.
That is really I should.
And as a result, of course, that leads to everything else that's happening right now, right, Auntie Anne? Yeah. Oh, wow.
Yeah. Okay, so thank you for spending this lovely morning with us. So before we end this morning session, next week we have Ted Cho and Emily Chen local seminar at 9 a.m. So please register yourself. And we have the week after next, we have another special speaker, Stephen Hu. Wow! We all like Stephen Hu. All right. So please do stay tuned to Stephen's 9 a.m. 16th of May. Put it down on your calendar.
9 a.m. per time.
Yes, wow. All of us like him so much.
Fantastic. Then, up close and personal with Vice President, Field Vice President Jackie Blasco. Got onto her and she said yes to me. She's also another one of like ITN who loves God, who loves Jesus, and she really, really is an amazing lady. I met her 3 years ago at Miami, and we clicked straight away, and she encouraged me to be someone like Auntie Anne, to share the gospel as we do the business. And she also won the Jerry Siciliano Award. She is going to be with us on the 25th of May. I cannot wait. She is really amazing.
Yes.
Field Vice President, 36,000 to 45,000 per 4 week pace.
Wow.
So last but not least, Carol, let us wish each and
everyone happy Mother's Day. Thank you. We love you, Anne. Thank you for spending this Saturday morning with us.
Thank you, Sabrina.
Hi, Anne.
Thank you.
Hi.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, all the listeners, for joining us this Saturday morning.
We need to get everyone to actually
Can everyone turn on your video while we're waiting? Next question is how did you follow up with people who say no to you already without destroying the relationship? What do you say or do differently each time when you ask?
Okay.
If people already say no to you, still want to maintain that relationship?
Yes, you have to maintain the relationship. No is not mean no all the time. So, but you don't irritate them, keep on sending your answer. Build relationship with other things. What they like, and sometimes go out with them. That's what you do. And then once a while, they will ask you. They automatically ask you. When they ask you, then you bring up again.
That is so just be patient.
Or they say, you look young. I say, oh, because of my product. I didn't ask them to take my product. I just said, because of my product. Is yes. it? Oh, you have this type of lifestyle because of MA. You know?
Wow, everything relating back to
relating to that, but not say they have to come in.
Maybe one more quick question. Yeah.
Okay.
What about where body language cannot be gauged and as you're in connection with text and phone only? So, you know, when you're texting people, you don't know their body language. How do you deal with that?
Okay, when you text them, if they don't reply, please don't text them all the time. Maybe you text them again. If you keep texting them, you will then annoy them, you see, or not, because they are no had the timing or the. Because you never know when is the time. 3 months, 6 months down the track, just giving the text or a video. That's what.
That's good. Yeah. Can I get everyone to please show your video so that we can take a group photo? Those of you who are not showing your video, please do so. Love to have everyone's face so that we can have a group photo.
I love to have you all.
So even Sabrina and Vincent and Karen, I know that you're doing your admin, but yeah, if you can also show your video, that will be awesome. Then I can help do some of the clip.
Yeah, thank you for taking time to join me.
Yeah, one last question, all right?
Okay.
My leader did not train or follow up with me since I signed up. We have a minor issue due to this, as I was eager to learn from her. She misunderstood me and had ignored and abandoned me since. I determined to succeed without a leader. Is it possible? You are so inspiring. Thank you, Anne.
It's possible. If you can reach out. There's so many people in MA. I feel that MA people will have the heart to, as long as you reach out to them. All right? It's possible without your leader. You can be successful. Okay? Because it's your business. Think of that. Don't. I feel people bring there, bring that, but think of yourself. Okay? So, what possible?
Well, you know what, Auntie Anne? We have nearly 200 people on this session with you this morning.
Yeah.
It's wonderful.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.